Actually, this song came to me in a very mysterious way. You know, I was working on the track when I suddenly felt inspired, and I went to a corner of the studio and I wrote the lyrics and the melody of the first half of the song, you know, the first verse and first chorus, in like 10 minutes, which is something that is very rare, you know, to do it simultaneously and in such little time. And when I least expected it, I was howling and panting, and that was it. But I think She-Wolf has a lot to do with the moment in which I feel I am. You know, I feel much freer now as a woman, a little more in touch with my own desires, and I tend to listen to myself a little more. Okay, what does Shakira want? You know, not what everybody else wants, but what do I really want, you know? And I think that the song deep inside is about that. It's about the individual liberties that we all have, the right to choose, the right to satisfy those subconscious desires, you know, in every man or every woman. It doesn't have to be necessarily women, but the She-Wolf is definitely a song that expresses that, I think.
Shakira, Shakira.
Oh, baby, when you talk like that, you make a woman go mad. So be wise and keep on reading the signs of my body.
I feel that I lived in a golden cage my entire life, and that's why I created this analogy for the video. I think that only age and time and experiences give you perspective on things, and you understand people a little bit, and you understand yourself a little more, and you forgive yourself too, you know, especially when you know that there's a non-thinking individual living inside of you, a little more like a more animalistic part inside of you, more primitive and basic side to you, that you're not only an intellectual person, you know, you're also a physical person and an animal person in a way, you know. So when you understand these things, you forgive yourself. You know, every time you screw up, you say, "That wasn't me. That was a She-Wolf. You know, that was the animal in me. That wasn't me. I have nothing to do with that."
I'm on tonight, you know, my hips don't lie, and I'm starting to feel you, boy. Come on, let's go real slow. Don't you see that this is perfect?
I worked with Pharrell, which was a great experience. I worked with John Hill, who's a very talented guy who lives in New York, very young, about my age. Very young guy. With some other friends of mine. I worked with Wyclef as well, writing songs, and it was great. It was a whole year of producing and writing this album, and that's why I took so long. You know, I usually take 3 years between albums, and that's just the time I need to tour. You know, my tours are usually a year long or more, and then I need another year to get into the studio. And I also have other aspects to my life that I have to dedicate my time to as well. It's gonna be a more electronic album. I think that the electronic aspect is the most dominant one in this record. It's gonna be hitting really hard on the bottom end, you know, and the foundation of the track is, I think, of all the tracks, is really solid, and it maintains that electronic element, and the synthesizers are really present. But I continue to do my own thing, my own mix, you know, my own cooking, which is, you know, bringing elements from different cultures, which is something that I enjoy a lot. I felt that I had to check out what was going on today and try to come up with something that could sound maybe 2010. You know, it's hard to predict what's going to happen in music, but I try to follow my instincts.
Lucky for my lips, not only mumble, still kisses like a thumb. Lucky for my
Yeah, the rest of the album is very electronic as well, very upbeat, very up-tempo, clubby. I decided to use many synthesizers. In every song there's a synthesizer, but there are also elements and influences from other parts of the world, African, Indian, Middle Eastern, even Colombian influences, all mixed in with the electronica, which is the dominant aspect in this album.